Their questions turned cartwheels around the table, and everyone soon caught the enthusiasm. Such exuberant conversation, I discovered, was not at all uncommon at their gatherings. Indeed, Blip's favorite toast and blessing over the meal was,
"To excellence in human communication."
I should mention that I wasn't particularly interested in what I was talking about that night. The topic of genetics only arose out of academic small talk about current research projects, and I would have been perfectly content to let it die a dullish death. Sophia and Blip, however, were determined not only to keep it alive, but also to convince it that life was all wind chimes and butterflies. They pumped me with questions as if they were the Heimlich cousins, and before I knew it, I was spitting pabulum all over the table and coughing every boring detail across the room. Sophia asked me if it was true that humans share 99% of their DNA with chimpanzees. I replied that it was actually 98.4%.
Fascinating. So what percentage do we share with dogs?
I don't know offhand, I said. But I do more than just compare genotypes. For instance, I'm currently working on mapping the genetic sequence that causes velvet worms to grow appendages.
Velvet worms?
They're little worms that walk around the forest floor. Worms with legs.
Worms with legs? Wow, Blip remarked sincerely. So what are you finding?
Well, I don't want to bore everyone. It's just boring, technical.
Not at all.
Sophia dismissed my attempt to pass the fat and continued to gaze at me with uninhibited curiosity.
Come on, tell us more about these velvet worms.
She was joined in her request by everyone else present, and I acquiesced. There's a gene which organizes the cells of the velvet worm into legs. If that gene were to be switched off, so to speak, the velvet worm wouldn't grow legs.